Okay, next up, we need to separate the, I still gotta pull the lower coolant hose clamp on the radiator that's down here, but we're gonna get this SERP belt off. Let's see, here's your tensioner. I don't know if there's a detent on this. 15 mil here. Gets that loose. Grab pictures of the orientation first. That's definitely beneficial. Breaker bar would have been nice too. I wonder if there's a little lock somewhere on this. Does not look like it. How far out is this gonna rotate? Dilemma. Got myself stuck on the pulley. Why don't we pop this off? Does that give me enough room to clear? Come on. Turd. There we go. Pulley. So all I did there was separate these, and this goes here for your fan spacing. Oh. Okay, now is the easy part, ish. Got a lot of gasket cleanup. Grab the belt, because we're definitely gonna be replacing this. I know it's low hours, but again, this thing's been sitting out in the field for God knows how long. Come on, let go. Let go. We'll bring this to the old tractor store, make sure we get one that's pretty much the same. We're gonna take a little break, I think, because now we're pretty much down to the last little bit, just the water pump. I don't know exactly what needs to come out, and I gotta figure out where I put the new pump. So let's take a look at the Amazon pump, wherever I left that. See how it looks, make sure everything looks proper before we go any further. But I really gotta think about this in terms of cheap out or pay up, and hopefully only have to do this once for quite a while. Next up, I'll pull this clamp and separate this from the housing down here. Should just pull up on that tube, whatever that coolant crossover is. Got oil everywhere, making a mess of things. Split our coolant tube passage. Do I need to pull this whole mount? Shoot. The answer is yes. This needs to come off now. Is that a 17? 17 or 18? Whichever one I think it is, it'll probably be bigger. Not the best with metric things. Not anymore, at least. I used to know them really well. Hardline pipe that runs down over here and into the thermostat over here. Come on. Let go. Wants to go. This one I had off not too long ago. such a pain because I don't really have much room to wiggle that. Let's see if I can wedge something in here and pry it out. Like a rubber grommet, but now that that one's separated, I should have a little more wiggle room on this side. Just like that. That went through there. This went through here. Throw this back over on the table. Okay, now back to making a mess. Take off the thermostat housing down here. At least try to. Of course she's gonna fight me. Really nice if it did take off this whole back section. You'd have a lot more room to get to things. Gasket actually stayed intact on there, but we'll take a look a little later. Then what? Do I need that pulley off? Probably 10 mils maybe. It is a 3-bolt. I thought it was a 4. Oh, it is working too, unfortunately. Spun that, some coolant moved around. There we go. Throw these back on. And what do we got, a bunch of 10s? Hopefully they're all the same size, we'll keep them in. So far they are. Oh, nope. Three long ones. Is that it? I don't see any more. One down here. Need a better look at this. So we got the water pump bolts separated. Should be good. Can't tell on that lower one from up top, and I can't tell on the bottom. No, we should be free. Let's grab some hammers. See what I can hit on this, what there's room to get to. Thank you.
she goes.
And another big old coolant mess. So here's the plastic impeller. These tend to wear out. This doesn't look too terrible, but I don't really know what I'm looking at. Doesn't feel bad. Seems like it's still splined in, but who knows. Was all of this even necessary? So many questions to ask myself right now. Oh well.
Remember, the long ones go on the left side here.
And I don't know what that little pocket is over here. Is it like another thermostat housing of some sort? What do you do? It looks like you're all part of one big cover. Not sure. I don't know if I need to open that up or not. But I'll grab the water pump anyway. Bolts for the water pump. What does this thing say? I don't know. It doesn't seem that bad to me. Don't feel a ton of play in it. I was really hoping that impeller would be a little bit more beat up. You guys can't even see what I'm looking at. I was really hoping the impeller would have been a little more beat up. There's a little bit of wear, but nothing too crazy. Doesn't feel like it's free spinning or slipping. So this could have been just a giant waste of time. Oh, why else is it getting hot? So, get to do some gasket scraping next, get all this cleared off, and then figure out what I'm gonna do. I think I left the water pump at the house, so I gotta run back there anyway. But we'll do that. Then I'll probably pull that thermostat off anyway, just because I got new gaskets for that already. Oh. Man, that's a lot of work just to get to that. That was the easy part. Water pump's off. Time to start cleaning up this gasket surface as best I can. It's really not a good way to get in here. I can't see anything from this side. Unless I kind of reach up on here. So, carbide scraping. Time lapse. I was on the fence on what I was going to do in terms of water pump things.
Got it all cleaned up. Everything's done, ready to go back together. I checked these. Like I said, 600 run hours. Stamped on the clock, so I don't know how accurate that is. Sorry. Smudgy. Here is the deal. I got the old water pump here. This is a plastic impeller. It's veined on both sides. The new one, this is the Amazon one, is not. However, this is metal. It's got a brand new bearing in there. Everything feels very nice on this assembly. But the cutaway for the fluid is a little bit bigger than this one is. They're the same height-wise about. I don't have the veining, like the factory one, on here, but the passages for coolant down here seem much deeper than the ones on the plastic housing. Not much, but it's noticeable, in my opinion. I don't think it's just a color difference there. The new gaskets fit proper on here as well, so I think we're in good shape there. And I went over to the tractor place to grab a new serp belt while it's all apart. We'll slap a new one of those on. The only issue I'm running into now is whether or not I want to wait for a factory pump, which I ordered from them today. I went out of town. I was over there last week when I got the original price and realized how expensive it was going to be. They said it was an in-stock item. They were ordered. They just haven't showed up yet. They're kind of on back order. So that means we need to make a decision. I ordered a pump through them. It'll be here Thursday at 6 a.m. Today is Tuesday. So that's 2 days of leaving this completely ripped apart with all the crazy weather that we've been having. I don't really want to do that. I like the idea of putting the factory part back in. I didn't want to spend the money at first, but there is a $75 or $80 core. So it ends up being about $350, $375 or so for the pump if I want to wait for a factory one, but it's also 2 days of wait time. I don't really have 2 days. I mean, I do technically, but I'm running out of time to try and get this stuff up and running before things start getting real busy again. So we're probably gonna leave this one here at this point. This will wrap up this video while I kind of think on this. I got a buddy coming by, might give me a hand. And we'll see what I can film or what I can't film. Everything else now is gonna be the opposite of this video in terms of reassembly. Gasket goes on there in between the pump housing, so gasket, and then the 10 bolts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 bolts. 8 bolts, crossover tube gets hooked back up. It's literally everything I just did in reverse. I'll probably throw a little bit of RTV around that gasket too, just to make sure it's not leaking. And one way or another, I'll figure out what I'm gonna do. I might split it into two parts because this thing all has to go back together, but it's kind of a pain in the ass to film it when I don't really know what I'm doing. I know all the piles and everything else, how to take everything apart. This was the teardown video. I think that's going to wrap this one up. We'll see. I don't know. I know this video is getting long. Everything else just goes back together the way it came apart. So if any hiccups or goofy things come up, I'll film that. But other than that, this is probably where we're going to leave it for now while I think about this. A lot of time, a lot of effort and energy, a couple hours easy to get everything apart enough to be able to access the water pump, and then the water pump was 10 minutes plus cleanup time. Power washed all of the stuff over there for the coolers and the radiator. There was a ton of crap in there, even though I cleaned them up not too long ago. So that's pretty much it for now. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, all those fun things, and hopefully this thing goes back together as easily as it didn't come apart. We'll catch you guys on the next one.